right, welcome back here to Phil Wainwright Gymnasium. We're getting set for the varsity contest. You're watching the Argus Voice Sports on RTC4.com and on Channel 4 in Rochester. Okay, before we get going here, I want to say a quick shout, sending some prayers up to the Bethany Christian High School family. They lost one of their own on Sunday in a tragic car accident. Anna Barnard, 18-year-old senior at Bethany Christian. She played basketball for the Lady Bruins team.
And played soccer for the Lady Bruins.
Well, she played 1 year for the boys team.
Yeah.
Last year, they didn't have enough girls. She played on the boys team and then played this year on the girls team. And tragic loss for the Lady Bruins and the Bethany Christian family.
The whole community is sad up there.
Yeah, want to. They're playing a game actually this evening at home versus Concord, and it's going to be a hard one. And just say a prayer for Bethany Christian, and I just want to take a moment, let everybody say a quick prayer in support of the Bethany Christian family. All right, so back to basketball. The world moves on, I guess. Tonight, the Argus Lady Dragons, number 3 in the Class A coaches poll, dropped from number 2 this week. Didn't play last week, but we still dropped a spot, but just two votes short. So they're hosting the Class A number 1 Michigan City Catholic Lady Blazers. The Lady Dragons are 11-0 on the season. They come in having matched the best start of a season of any program with the 2006-2007 Lady Dragons program that went 11-0 before falling in their 12th game. The Lady Dragons are looking to best that with a win here this evening. Michigan City is 9-0 on the year, and they boast a bunch of high-end players here. We'll get to that here in just a moment. So Argus is coached by Gary Teal. Coach Teal is 69-34 in his fifth season with the Lady Dragons program. He's 227-144 in his 17th season overall. Marquette is coached by Katie Colligan. She's 9-0 in her first season of varsity girls coaching. The last outing for the Lady Dragons actually ended up being 10 days ago, played here against New Prairie and won that game 75-31 on the 10th of December. The one game that was scheduled for the Lady Dragons last Thursday got postponed due to the weather, both Argus and Peru. The two teams that were set to play were not in school that day. So 10 days of rest, hopefully not rust, for the Lady Dragons.
Oh, boy.
Marquette in a similar boat. They haven't played since the 13th. Last Tuesday, they beat Calumet 75-27. They had a game scheduled for last Saturday, and that one was postponed as well due to the weather. Sagarin Ratings has the Lady Dragons at 6th in Class A, 96th overall. Marquette comes in the second spot in Class A in the 46th position overall. The opponent's record, Argus 48-90, and Marquette 43-60. The series over the last 15 years is 13-1, and that one loss for the Lady Dragons came last season. And this is not the Marquette team that we beat 13 times.
No,
they went shopping. To say, say it bluntly, I mean, they ended up firing their coach who brought these girls in after one season because of questionable means of getting the girls here.
Well, he coached them in a AAU program all the way up
until eighth grade,
and then told the parents, "You're bringing your kids here." Basically, bullied them into coming in where some certain things were said and done, And it was immediately after season that an inquiry was set by the state IHSAA. And it wasn't very long after that that we'd already heard the news that he was no longer in the program.
And they were, I guess Marquette was able to salvage the program when they brought Katie Collignan in. She's a former varsity assistant at University of Valparaiso.
Yeah.
And so everybody stayed. And this is what you got. You've got the two Nolan sisters who are 6 foot 2 inches tall. They play the guard spots. Sophia Nolan brings 18.4 points per game to the table, as well as 7.2 rebounds, 1.8 assists, 1.9 steals, and 1.1 blocks per game. Her sister Emma is scoring 15.9 points per game, 7.8 rebounds, 1.4 assists, 2.0 steals, and 2.0 blocks. The other two high-end members of that sophomore class, Morgan Crook, 10.7 points per game, 5 rebounds a game, and 2.9 assists and 2.1 steals. All three of them are shooting over 40% from behind the three-point line. Emery Joseph, their point guard, 3.2 points, 2.7 rebounds, but 8.1 steals per game, or assists per game, and 1.6 steals. So those four players, they're not the only four on the team, but those are the top four players for Marquette. Offensively, they're scoring 62.3 points per game, only giving up 37.4 points per game, and have an average margin of victory of 24.89 points per game. The Lady Dragons are led in scoring by senior Courtney Dunlap. She's scoring 24.5 points per game, rebounding 6.4, 5.9 assists, and 4.5 steals to go along with that. Macy Stricker is up to 7.2 points per game, 3 rebounds per game, 1.7 assists per game, and 3.4 steals per game. And she also has got a block. Average block,
rah.
One block per game.
Rah, one
so
block.
For a, no, one block per game.
One block, arr.
So she's got 11 blocks on the season. One note on Macy Stricker, she's coming off of her season high of 14 against
yep.
New Prairie, and she's averaging about 10 points a game over the last four or five games. So they're going to need her. She's going to have to step up and be very aggressive here this evening if the Lady Dragons are going to have a chance. Senior Anna Barlow is the leading rebounder for the Lady Dragons at 7.5, 6.1 points, 1.2 steals, and 2.6 blocks. The Lady Dragons are averaging 57.46 in the offensive average, which is 50th in the state in all classes. They are number one in the state in defensive average right now at 25.91. And that is in all classes. Their
all
average
classes.
Their average margin of victory is 31.55, and that is good for number 8 in the state. So it's going to be a challenge. It's going to be a tough game. But games like this are what's going to make the team better, win or lose, come tournament time. And speaking of the tournament, the Lady Blazers are going to be wanting a little bit of retribution here this evening. They got knocked off in the first game of the Caston Regional, the one that North White beat them, and then the Lady Dragons ended up winning against North White in the evening championship game by 20 to take the regional crown. So you can see they're just shooting all over the place here. The Lady Dragons go into the locker room, and the Nolan sisters, you know, they're giving each other shots, and they just shoot relentlessly until they keep making them. So we got about 2 minutes left to go here before the tip. Number one, Michigan City Marquette versus number three, Argus Lady Dragons. Keys to the game for Argus, they're going to have to play some tough defense.
Oh, boy.
Tough defense. They're going to have to limit, you know, they got to keep – they're obviously going to score more than our 25 points per game that we're allowing average, but we got to keep them a lot closer to the 25 than to their normal 62. So tough defense. Macy, Anna, Kennedy, Emily, and Morgan are going to have to all step up and be huge in this game. This is going to be You know they're going to be keying on Courtney Dunlap. They're going to be looking to shut down her dribble drive penetration. So the other three, four girls on the floor can't feel like the ball is a hot potato that they got to get out of their hands. And if they start getting a bunch of turnovers, we're going to be in trouble. Michigan City Marquette, they're going to want to shut down Courtney Dunlap. They're going to want to run at a faster pace. And the Nolan sisters are going to be looked at to dominate the game if the Marquette Lady Blazers are to move on to 10-0. So 20 wins here on the floor between the two teams on no losses on the season. So that's about to change here in about 32 minutes of gameplay or more maybe.
Yeah.
If the
Wetco Tippy Valley boys the other night, 96-92.
Four overtimes.
Four overtimes. That would have been such a great game to call.
There was a girls game that went Rochester and
yes.
Who were they playing? Went three overtimes.
Three overtimes. I don't remember the opponent, but it was
North Miami?
Good. Yeah, North Miami.
Yeah. Yep. So, yeah, chance there. Four overtimes. I've been by the gym in Swayze, Indiana, which boasts the record for most overtime game, most overtimes in one game, and I think it was 8 or 9.
Yep.
For the state record back in the 50s. So, all right, we're getting set to go here. We're going to get our national anthem and our starting lineups and get this one underway. Say that was one of the best national anthems. The sound system was having some issues, and just everybody just started going. And it was the
pep block over there got them started.
Yeah.
That's just wow. That's a really warm feeling. That just is very nice.
All right. So here's the starters for Marquette. Number 1, 6'2" sophomore Sophia Nolan. Number 10, a 5'6" soft junior, Mackenzie Maravich. Number 21, a 5'3" sophomore, Emery Joseph. Number 22, a 5'3" sophomore, Morgan Crook. And number 31, a 6'2" sophomore, Emma Nolan.
All right, for the Lady Dragons, number 10, senior Courtney Dunlap. Number 22, senior Kennedy Binkley. Number 24, senior Macy Stricker.
She's just a junior there, Andy.
Sorry. A junior. Number
don't rush
30,
it.
Senior Emily Calhoun. And senior number 50, Anna Barlow.
I don't want to do senior night this year.
Well, looky here. We got new center 16 here live on the court for pregame, getting ready for the tip-off. Filming the Lady Dragons as they huddle up and get ready to do battle. Oh boy, I tell you what, this is the game of the regular season right now. To tell you the truth, this is what all eyes are on. We had 22. We got the pilot news. We have 16. A lot of people are focusing on what happens here because this is the big game for the 1A.
All right, Sophia Nolan's going to go up against Anna Barlow for the tip here.
And it's a good tip, and Stricker gets the ball. Comes around over to Dunlap. Man-to-man defense will be tenacious out of Michigan City. Looks, Barlow gets it, fakes, over to Stricker. Stricker drives, Calhoun fakes, drives down, and gives it over to Stricker. Rotates to Dunlap, and the Dragons have no issues so far. Binkley looks. Dunlap gets it back at top of the key.
I like the patience of the Lady Dragons here to start the game.
Oh, and that's a throwaway from Binkley.
And I shouldn't have said that.
And the pressure's on. Kicks it over, down to Nolan. Nolan looks to have Dunlap down. Pins her. Puts it up, and it rolls in. So Dunlap's going to mark one, and there's a foul, and that's what Dunlap needs to do, take it right in and cause no one's to get in foul trouble.
All right. I don't know which one they're going to get.
21.
Sophia, 31. Emma?
No, 31, I'm sorry.
31. They're going to get Emma on the foul, and Courtney Dunlap is going to go to the line shooting two. If she can get penetration into the paint like that and cause the fouls for the Nolans, that's going to be a good thing for the Lady Dragons.
Yep.
So the first free throw is in with 7 minutes left here in the first. It's 2-1 Marquette. Second free throw is good for Dunlap.
Tie ball game, and that's a good sign for Dunlap. Starting off smooth as silk, and here comes the Lady Blazers. Going to rotate the ball quickly. Down low, Barlow, loose, and Binkley gets the ball. Here comes Dunlap. See Stricker low. Stricker puts it up, and that's a great transition bucket out of the Dragons. Good vision from Dunlap, and Stricker puts it in.
Good job by Stricker running the floor right there.
And there's a foul on Barlow.
She's got to do the work before that pass is made. She was settling behind Sophia, and they got called for the foul.
It's not like she's small. She just needs, if she's going to let her catch it, let her catch it, let her turn and face up, but you just keep your hands straight. Don't create the fouls and the easy opportunities. Quick three, and she didn't get set, and it's off the mark, and it's shown.
All right, 4-2, the Lady Dragons. We got 6:30 left to go here in the first quarter, and there's a Lady Dragons ball off of a out of bounds on a missed shot by Emma Nolan.
Stricker gets it, looks over, Dunlap crop key, Calhoun fakes, over to Binkley. Barlow turns and shoots a quick one. It's off the mark, and it's tipped over to Nolan. It's 2-on-1. Dunlap does not need an easy foul here, and there's a layup, and it's missed. Over to back. And
yes.
It's over to back on Nolan,
yes.
And it's going the other end. And that's on
Sophia.
Number one, Sophia.
So there's one foul on each Nolan sister, and a good job of blocking out that time by Courtney Dunlap. So two team fouls now for Michigan City. 6:01 left to go.
Well, they're going to have to be as tenacious as possible on every rebound and make them fight for it, because that's the only way the Dragons are going to be able to keep into this. Barlow gets it. Oh, gee, Wilkers. There is three fouls right there not called. That is craziness. Bound in the corner. Fakes, drives, kicks it all the way out. No one over. Here's a wide open three, and it's a long, high shot, and it's off of Calhoun. Oh, I thought it was definitely off of Argus.
Nope.
Well, I tell you what was the official waiting on? She totally had fouled Barlow on that position play two or three times. I tell you. Stricker has it. Nice and relaxed. Oh, and it's tipped. And there's a foul. Not called, and it's kicked out of bounds. Ay, ay, ay. These officials better get control of this game because they're going to have both sets of fans all over them real quick. Oh, my. Stricker over to Barlow. Down to Dunlap. Dunlap looks, puts it up, and it's good. Kicks it over. No one for a long three, and it's way off the mark. Rebound, Dunlap gets the ball, and here comes the Lady Dragons. Comes across. Oh, and she's decked from behind.
It's going to be on Crook, her first foul.
And Dunlap goes down super hard. Yikes.
Third team foul. 4:49 left to go here in the first. 6-2, Argus with the lead. And Dunlap
tough
feeling
play.
A little rough. But she seems to be okay.
Let's see if she does it off her back. Nope, they got her turned so she can't. Gives it over to Stricker. Stricker back to Dunlap. And it's going to be a physical game tonight. You can tell it already. Dunlap rotates to the top of the key. Fakes, going to drive. Kicks it over to Calhoun. Over to Barlow. Gives it to Dunlap low. Dunlap for two, and the Dragons are up. 8-2.
Beautiful ball work right there, and nice post move by Dunlap.
And look at the Barlow, and there's a throwaway, a turnover, and it's Dragons' ball. And the coaches take, and there it is. The coach was trying to wait as long as possible to call a timeout, but she is forced to early on in the first quarter.
4:20 left to go in the first. It's an 8-2 Argus lead. And Coach Colligan for Marquette calls a timeout.
Well, I like what they've seen. We've rotated out and put Dunlap down in the post position and drawn out the fire on Barlow. Here we are, Mr. Trophy. Go see Amy Stone, 574-892-5005. Down there next to Argus Do It Best Hardware, and Argus makes dash plaques for trophies, engraving, your award source since 1975. Well, I tell you, First 2 minutes, 3 minutes impression. What do you got there, Coach Stricker?
Well, excellent so far.
excellent
I watched a little bit of the matchup last year, and the passion, the drive, the ball handling, the movement right now that the Lady Dragons are showing is 100% better than what we saw early on against the Lady Blazers last year. I think they went up there, you know, it was the first year.
They were nervous.
They'd not been used to Marquette being this good, and they went up there last year, and I think they got a little shell-shocked early on. So.
Oh, they were shell-shocked, but here we go. I think the coin has turned over, and now Michigan City's a little bit shell-shocked at the moment. Stricker gets it, looks, fakes. Barlow was open for a second. Dunlap has it. Dunlap goes, puts it up, and it's just off the mark. And that's a good shot, and that's what we want to have. Here's a quick three. It's a high archer, and it's off the mark.
Good rebound by Binkley.
Here comes Dunlap. Dunlap goes, puts it up, misses. Barlow with the rebound and puts it in for two, and Dunlap hits hard. She was shoved, and she's hurting. Nolan gets it, turns, and misses. Rebound, and Stricker with a huge rebound. And Coach Teal says, hey, settle up for a second. Dunlap's hurting a little bit. And, boy, it's going to be an ugly, rough game when we talked about it. And there's a ball to Barlow. Calhoun.
I really like the adjustment that Coach Teal's made putting Barlow at the high post.
Stricker tries to get it over. It's tipped out of bounds. Nolan's just got a little bit high hands.
Well, you're not going to get that around 6'2 with long arms right there, but it was a good idea by Stricker.
And look at Dunlap. She's holding her wrist still, and her hand's tingling, and she's not feeling real well after the second nasty hit. She's going to drive. She goes up, lays it in. It just misses. Rebound. Barlow gets it back to Dunlap. She's got it open, puts it up, and it's in, and the Dragons are up 12-2. Defense is coming down. Here they are. Man to man. It's 2-3 zone.
You can see Nolan. Yep. She's getting mad. She's really sticking her elbow. That could be an offensive foul if the refs are going to call
Rebound Stricker
it.
Again on the backside of the goal.
Sophia Nolan on Anna Barley. Got to watch
gonna
that.
It's going to be a hard fight game. She is going to prove her mettle tonight. Barlow is going to be tough. Stricker, Calhoun for three. Just off the mark. Kicks it out. Rebound Nolan. And she travels.
Four turnovers in the early going. We got a sub coming
and
in.
And Nolan's out, and I think Coach wants to talk to her and say, hey, settle down.
Well, we got a Nolan going out, another Nolan coming in. Yep. That's number 25, Hannah Nolan, the older sister who's a senior this year.
See if her senior experience might help settle him down a bit. Calhoun or Dunlap. Travel.
Yeah, she's a little out of her element right out there. She didn't get her feet set.
And Coach is trying to explain to Nolan down there, say, hey, don't shuffle your feet. Just keep your hands up. Use your height. Use your arms to try to deter the Dragons, because when you reach, then they go around you, and that's where we are right at the moment. Binkley out, playing man-to-man. Stricker comes in with the help. Fake, long shot, thrown up, rebound Calhoun. And I tell you what, I've not seen Michigan City so out of sorts. I don't know if it's just that they are, but some of their shots have just not been quality that you would expect out of this program.
I think the intensity from the Lady Dragons has got them really rattled right now, and if they can keep it up.
Barlow, little jumper.
Oh,
and it's in and out.
That was three-quarters of the way in before it popped out for Anna.
Here comes the Lady Blazers. Dragons playing down. Well, I don't know. Here comes the back door. Kick back over.
Good read that time.
In, and there's a foul by Dunlap.
And they're not going to say she was shooting. Oh, my goodness gracious. How can you call that on the shot?
That's got to be on the ground.
No, they're calling shooting.
How? Her back was to the – she didn't even receive the ball.
That's a terrible call. That was not a shooting.
She didn't receive the ball.
That was not a shooting foul whatsoever.
She didn't receive the ball. How could she be shooting? That's terrible. That is beyond terrible.
First,
and now we got Dean Hubbard over here. He's – like I said, everybody's here watching this one. Oh, boy.
Is he?
I don't know.
Oh,
if
he's got the Kyles down there with the Dragon. Two for two for Sophia.
I cannot believe that they gave that a shooting foul. Her back was on the goal. She didn't even receive the basketball. Ah,
all right, so
word.
We got a sub. Number 12, Dia Rawlings, a 5'5 sophomore, comes into the game for Marquette. Starting five still on the floor for the Lady Dragons.
Well, I don't mind seeing Stricker if she ends up taking a quick break. Barlow gets the ball from Dunlap, misses. The ball's loose.
Shoot
and
that.
It's going to be Dragons. Yep,
shoot
off
that,
the glass,
Anna.
Off the glass.
Yeah,
honey.
She tried to make it go in, and she didn't shoot it. It's going to stay Lady
and
Dragons.
Here comes
ball.
Morgan Dunlap. Let's see who's going out. Stricker or Calhoun? Calhoun's out. I kind of would like to see Macy get a two-minute break or a minute break to catch her breath.
Yeah, she's doing all right.
She's doing good, but I like to see that rotation. That,
don't let the red color fool you. She's doing fine.
Yeah. Binkley. Stricker, a little jumper, and it's just off the front of the rim.
Anna, don't get that foul right there.
Yep, and she refrained from doing it. Here's. They're going to try to get it to Nolan as much as they can down low.
Well, man-to-man here for the Lady Dragons.
Fakes, kicks it back over, and Dean Binkley, she's not going to let her shoot the three.
Oh, somebody's
loose, and here comes Stricker with the ball. 31 seconds. The Dragons are going to wait and take the last shot. Stricker, and the Dragons have no problems letting the clock run. And I tell you what, so far, this is what we wanted to see. Wasn't sure we were going to get it, but we are definitely getting a show so far.
Nice pass from Dunlap to her sister. Beautiful drive there by Courtney, and she found
And that's a great first half, first quarter out of the Lady Dragons. Dragons up by 10, 14-4. That's been some quality basketball. That's the best they've played all season.
Oh, by far. So 14-4 is the Lady Dragons lead here after one. That was a beautiful drive, and then Courtney did a good job. She drew everybody to her. Morgan found a little spot on the short corner and went in for an easy bucket. So great start here in the first quarter for the Lady Dragons. Not necessarily what I was thinking was going to happen, but definitely what I was hoping would happen here Lady Dragons.
The Dragons cannot let off the throttle. Coach Teal has to keep his girls hammering down them, working hard, because if nothing else, it creates very frustrations and very amount of fouls, so it's going to only benefit the Dragons. And you can see it when they already pulled one no one out, and they're going to have to sub her in and get her other sister a break, but this is very, very good work from the Lady Dragons. It is a long game. It's not near over, but so it's a great start.
The Blazers' 4 points have all come on from Sophia Nolan. She's got one field goal and two free throws. Courtney Dunlap leads all scorers with 6 8-points in the first. Macy Stricker, Morgan Dunlap, and Anna Barlow all have two.
Well,
second
the
quarter.
Dragons have held Michigan City 1 for 9 from the field. That is a great, great statistic.
All right. Still just one, two Nolans in, but not Emma. Emma is out. Sophia and Hannah are in for the Lady Blazers. Dinkley with tough defense up top on Rawlings.
And there's a kick. Good feet.
You see her St. Francis bound soccer player skills right there. Good job by Kennedy Dinkley.
Well, yeah. It's hard not to be excited for a good quality game. And then when the Dragons are coming out like this, it gets everybody amped up. They were super excited. Here she goes. She's got a line. Pulls back. Kicks it over. No one kicks it over. Rotates. Fake shot. And it's rebound by Stricker. And there's a reach-in foul. And that's another great work. Stricker, that's her third from that backside. And just keeps catching the ball.
That's on Crook. That's her second foul here in the first half. So Coach Colligan might want to get her out of the game. Not sure.
Well, Coach is telling them, hey, get back. There's no reason to foul underneath their basket. It's not going to do them any good when we're all the way at the other end.
Four team fouls on Marquette here so far in the first half.
Dunlap gets it, fakes, going to drive. Over to
Barlow for three.
And it's off the mark. Binkley battles, and it's loose. And it's going to be Dragons' ball.
Wow.
Beautiful, great work out of Binkley to try to fight for that rebound. What is Barlow? When you're feeling it, you're feeling it. You're taking a chance. She was wide open.
Her
dad's sitting down here in front of us thinking, hey, girl, where's that from?
Well, she does have a smooth shot about 15, so she wanted to try and see if she could get a three in.
All right, ball is in. Dragons have it. I want to see that intensity, that fight and desire that they had. Over the back. All right, that's a foul quicker in life. Dunlap, the freshman. And
there's a foul on Nolan.
Nolan.
That's going to be your second on Sophia. So two fouls. That's.
And here comes Emma for Sophia.
Yeah.
And I tell you what, Morgan Dunlap says, listen here.
Look at Sophia. She's very rattled.
Oh, yeah.
She does not get rattled. I've seen her play a lot of times. She does not get rattled. But she's very rattled right now.
I think the entire squad for Michigan City is Stricker, a little jumper, and it's just off the mark. I don't mind when we're missing because we are taking quality shots. We're not rushing anything. There's just a couple of them haven't fallen. Good shots for the Lady Dragons. Kicks it out. Oh, travel. See her pick step, little stutter step before she passes it back. No one has it way out top. Barlow looks good defense out of Barlow.
Emma is not as smooth out top as her sister.
And the Dragons are getting rallied. Listen to the fans. And the coach over here is not sure what they're supposed to be running because they're not doing anything at the moment. And I think it's just the defense of the Lady Dragons. She rotates, looks now wide open, and it's way off the mark.
No rebound. And there's going to be a foul. I don't know who they're going to get. Barlow?
Nope, I think it's on Binkley, and that's her second.
2-2, yep. So that's her first, isn't it?
That's her first, yes. Here's looks, kicks it in. Drives, and she just travels trying to run it in for no reason. And the coach over there, I got to like it. She's been around basketball a long time because all she did was clap and said, yeah. She looks at her bench because they're yelling, and she's like, Stravel.
Yeah.
You know, she understands the game.
5:49 left to go here in the first half. 14-4 is her score.
Crossover. Here comes Dunlap for a layup. And it misses. It's
already They're going to call the foul. It's going to be on
Carrick,
Nolan.
Number 22. It is.
22?
Yeah, it's their third.
Crook, yeah.
Crook's third.
Oh,
already.
She's definitely going to have to go to the bench.
And there goes
yep.
number 10.
Maravich is going to come back in.
Maravich is coming back in, and out comes Crook.
So Crook is one of their top three-point shooters, and she's on the bench with Sophia Nolan right now.
Binkley gets it. Dunlap has it back. Stricker's open. Let's see what happens. Over to Morgan Dunlap. Barlow. Morgan has it. Fakes. Stricker back over to Courtney. Barlow. Back over to Dunlap. Courtney crossover. Stricker. Fakes. Goes. Nope. Comes back around.
It's all right. We can run some clock right here.
The Dragons do not need to rush. This is good quality offense from them. Stricker. Three. And it's just off the mark. Barlow with the rebound.
Anna.
Foul. And that's an easy foul to call.
Second foul. Anna's got to be smart right there and just let that go. The girl had the rebound. And Rachel Kuntz is going to come in with two fouls on Anna Barlow. With 4:53 left to go.
Well, it was a good attempt from Stricker, and Barlow's got to be smarter than that. All right, Dragons holding a 10-point lead at the moment, and they need to play that tough defense.
All right, they're looking there for Emma.
Drives down, kicks it out. Shot, and it's good.
All right, three-pointer Emma Nolan. First points of the game for Emma.
Only second field goal all game. Crossover, there's a foul. And the Dragons keep this up, and they're going to be shooting a 1-1, which they are now.
Joseph with her first foul of the game. That's the seventh, yeah. So Courtney Dunlap going to the line, shooting 1-1. 4:18 left to go in the half. They're going to be in the 1-1 the rest of the way out.
Well, I tell you what, the Lady Blazers have been caught off guard by the tenacity of the Dragons. First one's
good. 3-for-3 from the free throw line for Courtney. See if she can make it 4-for-4.
And a girl from Blazers is talking to her, trying to get her off her game, but they don't know Dunlap very well. She
two
is a
for
pressure
two,
player.
4-for-4, 16-7. 4:18 left to go in the first half.
All right, 2-3 zone.
Kick ball, Binkley. Good defensive effort.
That's all right. We don't mind that. They come down, but now it breaks their rhythm. It breaks their rhythm, and now here comes the throw-in from the side.
Looks like man-to-man now for the Lady Dragons. They're switching up.
And that messes with
people.
No,
they're back to the zone. Good collapse that time by Binkley.
Oh,
are they?
Word.
Really?
Oh. It's terrible.
That's Binkley's second foul, so
Dragons
4-4.
Well, this could be an ugly play for us. Position on Kuntz, and Kuntz gets the foul, and she's shooting two.
Well, that was a good job by Hannah Nolan. She got good position, body position on Rachel Kuntz, and nice inbounds pass, and she's going to go to the line shooting two. And that's going to be the first foul of the game for Rachel Kuntz. And the sixth team foul on the Lady Dragons. So Hannah Nolan at the line shooting two. And she's off the back iron on the first one.
Misses the first one. I tell you what.
All right, second free throw is
good.
Off the front and good for Hannah. 1-for-2.
All right, 16-8. Dragons still going pretty well. Working hard. Kicks it over. Stricker has it. Back over to Dunlap. To Dunlap. She has the sophomore on her. Oh, what a fake! Goes up. misses. Binkley with the rebound. Dunlap gets the ball back. What a fake out of Morgan Dunlap. She had to just finish that play, and that would have been something to see. Stricker gets it, battles, and still misses. Gets it. I tell you what, they're all over. I cannot believe that they can't blow the whistle. And out comes Binkley, and comes Calhoun.
That was a good strong post up there by Macy Stricker. Had two girls hanging on her, and no call.
Yeah, and still is able to get some sort of a shot off with being hammered. I cannot believe it.
Kuntz gets the ball in. Dunlap. Stricker's wide open. Thought about it. Stricker. Kuntz. Morgan Dunlap cuts through, back over to Stricker. Stricker relaxed, gives it over to Dunlap for three, and it's off the mark. A rebound. Dragons back in man-to-man. Kicks it over. Here's a long three, and it's going to be long, and Stricker gets another rebound. She was looking at Calhoun, and Calhoun didn't put her head up when she was going down the court. Dunlap for two, off the mark. Tips, battles, tips out, and it goes over to Calhoun. Stricker, smart. What a smart play by Stricker. Baits him in, pulls him out, and says, hey, we got time. We're not rushing it. We're going to use the time wisely. Rotation out of the Dragons, been very smooth. And a travel out of Dunlap.
Shuffled her feet there. First turnover of the second quarter for the Lady Dragons. Only the third turnover of the game. Been a pretty clean game. We're going to have a timeout on the floor called by Coach Colligan for the Marquette Lady Blazers. With 2:10 left to go, Lady Dragons are up 16-8 over the number one Lady Blazers from Michigan City Marquette. First Federal Savings Bank is your source for all your banking needs in Rochester, Indiana, at 310 East 9th Street. You can call them at 574-223-2128 or visit them online at firstfederalbanking.com. They also have locations in Plymouth, Bremen, Elkhart, and Mishawaka for all your banking convenience. First Federal Savings Bank of Rochester.
Well, I tell you what. Been a good first half so far, but I want the Dragons' intensity to get back up where it was at the beginning. And Pep Block working their best to keep the girls fired up.
Don't forget, you can tweet us at Argus Sports.
2 minutes and 10 seconds left in the half. We knew it was going to be a low-scoring affair and a defensive battle. Good defense. It's man-to-man. Caddy corner all the way over. Looks, kicks it back out. And over again. Dunlap steals the ball. And fouled on Nolan. Number foul. Nolan decks her, and she knows she did.
Second foul of the half for Sophia.
That's
or Emma.
Emma. Now Emma. It's two and two and three. Nolan, and Cook.
Crook.
Sorry.
So Morgan or Courtney Dunlap is going to go to the line, shooting 1-1 for the Lady Dragons.
Oh man, and I think it's just because they have them so rattled, because she is not a type of player that you would think would be create that such an easy foul.
Oh, Courtney misses Dunlap. The first.
Could have used those points.
Only 2 points here in the second quarter for the Lady Dragons.
Rebound. Throws it and misses. Rebound, Kuntz.
Good job by Rachel. Clear it out, Rachel. There you go. Good rebound. Good job by Kuntz that time. Strong, strong rebound.
Dunlap relaxes. Uses some of the clock coming across the timeline.
All right, minute and a half left to go here in the first half.
Kuntz gets it out top. Side. Back over to Stricker. Calhoun.
This is the kind of game the Lady Dragons need to play. They got to have a low-scoring affair. They don't want to run the ball with the Marquette team.
Back over to Morgan Dunlap. The Stricker fakes. Has a set. Puts it over. Calhoun backing around. Dunlap's at the top of the key. Over to Kuntz.
And
throws it away.
Rachel. looking to go into Dunlap and went 3 feet over top of her head.
Bought.
Good defense
stolen by Courtney
Dunlap.
Morgan tipped it. Courtney steals it. She's got a 1v1. She goes after it, puts it up, and it's good.
Beautiful job by both Dunlap sisters. Morgan with excellent defense, and Courtney gets the steal right there and puts it in for two and makes it 18-8, back to a 10-point advantage for the Lady Dragons.
Tipped, and it, no one recovers it. Looks, tries to force it down. Over, and there it balls into Kuntz. Gets it and puts it in for two.
Yeah, she did good job with her body there. That's Hannah Nolan. Good work and was able to get the position on Kuntz.
10 seconds left. Dragons up 18-10. Dunlap looks, going to drive, puts it up, and it's good! And one!
Bucket counts. Is that on Emma?
Nope, that's on the other Dunlap, number 25.
Okay, first on Hannah.
And out.
Sophia is going to come in for Emma.
With 1 second left, you're risking
They're wanting a rebound and a long shot. And Dunlap has a shot here to give the Lady Dragons an 11-point advantage.
She's going to put this one in, and it's smooth as silk. I told you.
No silly fouls here.
And the ball is no chance. And that's way too late. And what a half out of the Lady Dragons, 21-10. Holding Michigan City, number one in the state, to 10 points in the first half. Holy cow.
All right, I'm going to add up some totals here. You want to read through? There you go.
I don't think I can. Here we are back with the Sports Zone Sports Complex of Northern Indiana, 2923 Van Vactor Drive in Plymouth. You can come see Rick and Barb Miller, Ted Hayden, Doug Griffiths, Dwayne Morton, or myself. You can get into futsal, basketball, volleyball. We're going to have lacrosse, softball, baseball, football, personal trainings. And I tell you what, I can't hardly talk about advertisers. I'm so wound up over this one so far. First Federal Savings, firstfederalbanking.com, Rochester, 310 East 9th Street. Also located in Plymouth, Bremen, Elkhart, Michigan, Mishawaka, to service all your banking needs. 574-223-2128.
It's supposed to go the other way.
I know. Hush it.
All right. So first half totals for the Michigan City Marquette Lady Blazers, 10 points. Sophia Nolan with four.
Wow.
She has one field goal and two free throws. And she is the leading scorer. Emma has one three-pointer. She has three. And Hannah has a field goal and a free throw for three. So all three Nolans have scored, but only totaling out to 10 points. Six first-half turnovers, which isn't terrible, but they seem to come at critical times for the Lady Blazers. And here's the tale for the Lady Blazers. Sophia Nolan, two fouls. Emma Nolan, two fouls. Hannah Nolan, one foul. And Morgan Crook, three fouls.
Yep.
So some foul issues for the Lady Blazers here. Lady Dragons, 21 first half points, 15 by Courtney Dunlap, two by Macy Stricker, two by Morgan Dunlap, and two by Anna Barlow. And Binkley has two fouls, and Barlow has two fouls. Five first half turnovers is all I tallied for the Lady Dragons. So the halftime score here from Phil Waybright Gymnasium is 21-10. And this is exactly the game that I was talking about that the Lady Dragons were going to have to play in order to beat Marquette. They had to shut down the Nolans, and they could not let them run. We had to get them closer to our average than to their average. And I didn't think we'd be this much closer to our average than their average.
I tell you. Well, the biggest thing is the defense, by switching it, we saw Coach Kelsey do it in JV, switching it from zone back to man-to-man to zone to man-to-man and not keeping them on their toes has really changed things. And they are 3 of 17 from the field. So that's just crazy, crazy statistics. In the first half, might not have caught it, but they are 3 of 17 from the field.
3 of 17 from the field.
Oh, boy. Keeping them on their toes, and the Dragons just need to keep this up, keep working hard, waiting for the smart, high-percentage shots like they have been,
and just keep this going. It's just very, very good basketball at the moment. I tell you.
All right. Well, we're going to take a little bit of a break here. Okay. I need to catch my breath. We're going to flip it down here. They're doing a little halftime ball action, and we're just going to put her down there and zoom out. Alex is yelling at me for getting away from his camera. And we're just going to let you see a little bit of halftime action here from Phil Waybright Gymnasium. We've got about 6.5 minutes to go here before the start of the second half, where the number 3 Argus Lady Dragons are up 21-10 over the Marquette Lady Blazers. Welcome back here. We got about a minute and a half left to go before the start of the second half of action here from Phil Waybright Gymnasium. The Argus Lady Dragons are up 21-10 over the number 1 team in Class A, the Michigan City Marquette Lady Blazers. And, Andy, we're 16 minutes away from a possible upset
here
this evening.
What did John Harrell predict the score to be?
It was like a 49-42 Marquette win.
All right.
Which we've done, you know, we've talked about it. I talked about it in the pregame. We had to play our game. We had to play our defensive effort that we normally do. And that meant allowing, you know, a low amount of points. And so far we've done that. We still got another half here to go. We can't let up on the defensive effort the Lady Dragons have put forth.
Well, I tell you what, it's been an amazing first half, and the Dragons need to continue. The Dragons need to continue with that fire, that spark that they had at the beginning of the game. They got to battle, they got to work hard, and they got to make sure that we keep this in balance. It's going to be Lady Dragons basketball, and we need to start off with a nice set of points here, maybe even a 3, and then get a quick stop to start breaking down the confidence that the coach might have gave him at halftime with a good speech here for the Blazers. Calhoun for 3, and it's good. There it is. I just talked about it.
First 3-pointer of the game for the Lady Dragons comes off of the shot from Emily Calhoun, and that opens up 24-10.
And the Dragons really have a shot line. Here one from Crook, way high arch, and it's no good. Rebound. Calhoun gives it back to Dunlap. Now you got both the twins, no one's back in. So you got 3 players out there in a little bit of foul trouble early on. Ball's in, it's tipped out. Calhoun gets it. Over to Binkley. Stricker. Stricker's been on. I wanted to see her take that. I saw her during warm-ups at halftime with Stone battling with her, and she put a couple in. I wanted her to take that confidence and take that shot. She was open. Dunlap cuts across. Calhoun. Stricker fakes. Binkley. Dunlap. Rotates. Puts it up. Nothing. Oh, could have got called for a travel there. Nolan with the easy one, puts it up, and it's good. I want to see the Dragons rotate, run the play. Man, look at the hands all over the players. Barlow has it. Dunlap says clear out. Fouled, and there it is. Foul by Nolan. Emma Nolan with another foul, and it's a silly foul. She should know better at that arm down swat like that, it is a very hard foul on Dunlap. So to think, if nothing else, they're going to let her know, if you come in, you're going to pay the price. Dunlap's at the line shooting two. First one's good. Dunlap is playing to the senior level and puts it in. Huge free throws out of her.
That's seven made free throws for the game for Courtney Dunlap.
Ball's in. Barlow hands up, throws it, and they're going to call a foul on Stricker. That's okay. I'll take that. That's only her second the entire game.
It's her first.
First. That's her first. What? Ay, ay, ay. I'm misspoken. That's great work out of her. And it didn't go to Barlow. And now, let's see if no one can come back and answer Dunlap's two mates. First one's in. Almost a little short, gets the roll. Let's see if we can get a nice over the back on a rebound here, and that would just be fine by me. Second one's up, and it's off, and rebound Barlow. So she can't match it, and the Dragons get the ball. Dinkley makes her run, fakes. Dunlap gets it back. Stricker almost had it. Dunlap goes, gives it over to Binkley. Stricker makes the run. Now it goes back over. She tells Calhoun, here we go, make the run. They're scared to pressure at the moment. Dunlap drives, goes back, fakes, gives it to Binkley.
Oh, nice pass to Binkley.
Oh, what a pass.
What a pass.
Binkley with a great bucket. Pass by Dunlap with a left-handed pitcher's mound. Boom, right to her. Kicks it out. Here's Crook for a long three. She's been off all night, and she still is. Ball's loose. Rebound. Throws it away, and the Lady Blazers retaining it. Crook again for a long three, and it's finally in. One of five.
28-16, 4:40 left to go here in the third quarter.
Dragons doing very well battling. I want to see Stricker take it to Crook, get her another foul. Gives it over, and there's a foul on Nolan. That's four. That's four on Emma Nolan. Four.
All right, they're getting ready to come back in with Hannah Nolan here. Emma gets her fourth foul of the game. And they also have Dia Rawlings.
Yep. And out comes number 10,
Maravich.
And look at Coach is trying to settle her down. She's crying over here. And that's just how bad it's been for her. Barlow gets the ball, looks.
Come on, take that in strong, Barlow.
Binkley has it. Gives it over. Calhoun for three. And it's off the mark. Loose. No one gets it. It's loose. Throws it up. Rebound, Barlow gives it over to Dunlap. Here comes Binkley. Stricker's in the corner. Dunlap to Stricker. Stricker fakes, puts it up, and it's blocked by Nolan. And then there's a foul by Stricker.
Well, 6'2" girl, I told her she's got to go up strong with the shot fake and get her in the air, and she didn't do that, and yeah. She gets blocked and then creates the silly foul from the other end of the floor. Well, second foul here of the game for Macy and second team foul of the quarter.
The Dragons need to keep battling, working hard. They already have them frustrated. And here comes Morgan Dunlap's going to check in for the Dragons. No one versus Dunlap puts it in for two.
Still a long way to go here. The Lady Dragons can't get complacent. They're only up 10 with 3:40 left to go in the third. And Coach Teal's going to get a timeout here. 3:38 left to go. 28-18 is the score. Lady Dragons are ahead of Michigan City. I'd like to thank Rob Herford of H&H Contracting and Herford Home Inspections. Also wish him a great big old happy birthday today. He does concrete work, gutters, roofing, general contracting, and home inspections. You can give Rob a call at 574-498-6013. He'll give you an inspection of your property you're looking to buy, and then he can also help you fix it up when you do get it purchased. Rob Herford, 574-498-6013, and happy birthday to Rob. All right, full timeout on the floor. 3:38 left to go here in the third. And Lady Dragons, let's see, halftime was 21-10, so it's 7-8, so not too bad here for the start of the third quarter for the Lady Dragons. Just got to keep pressing away. And, you know, we've seen Sophia Nolan get a couple shots. We've seen Crook finally hit a three, so we've got to keep the pressure defense going.
Well, you now you got Morgan Dunlap in for Calhoun, and I like it. I think that's a good sub. Nothing wrong with changing it up a bit. But Calhoun had a great three, and then Morgan, when she was in, had real nice ball faking, was taking it right at him, trying to draw some fouls. Binkley gets the ball. Stricker comes through. Back over to Dunlap. Binkley gets the ball. I want to see Stricker open. Barlow for a little jumper. It's off the mark. Tipped. Taken by, and it's blocked. Dunlap goes, and it's blocked again. We're going to call a foul on Dunlap.
Morgan Dunlap with a foul. That's going to be the first of the game for her, third team foul.
That's kind of a freshman mistake there. She took it up kind of against the player that's huge. All she had to do is bring it back out, reset the offense, and run down the clock some more. Would have probably been a better play overall. But you got to like the chance that she took. She took and showed some tenacity and intensity to try it. Crook goes. Blocked. Out of bounds. And it's going to be Dragons. Morgan's going to throw it into her sister. Dunlap and Dunlap at law. Here comes Dunlap across. And now the Dragons are getting a swirl. Going to be moving the ball. They need to watch the collisions when the Dragons are making a cut. Michigan City is just running right into them on purpose. Barlow, little jumper, fakes. Back over to Stricker, to Dunlap. Dunlap goes right around her, kicks it back out to Courtney. Drives, puts it up, and it's just off the mark. Oh, my word. Touch foul. Touch foul. Ay, ay, ay. Well, not a bad shot out of Courtney. She's made a bunch of those earlier. She's trying to draw the foul. So the Dragons need to get out on them. Defense. You can't sit back and wait. Crook puts it in the corner. Long three. And it's good. Dragons up by 7. Coach has slowed the game down, and I don't like it. I want to see the run and possession that they had at the beginning. Crook was a reach in. Barlow. Dunlap. Stricker's open. Foul. Ay, ay, ay. Smack the hands all you want tonight. Morgan Dunlap gets it. Run into by Nolan. That's such a foul. Body check. Here we go. Dunlap sets it up. Jumper. Puts it in, and it's a smooth shot. Rotates. Man to man. Tries to force it in to Nolan down low. Kicks it all the way out, and it's a throwaway. Good defense out of the Dragons.
All right, 51.6 seconds left. 30-21, Lady Dragons with a 9-point lead. And it's going to be Lady Dragons ball here, left or right.
One shot is what we're going for. Dunlap called it out.
Now he's got a count. They're scared to pressure on Dunlap because she got a quick step and dribble. Barlow gets it. Back door, Stricker. 22 seconds. There's a foul.
That's on Joseph. That's her second, team's fourth, team's third. 15 seconds left here in the third quarter.
Relax. Drives, misses. Barlow misses. No one goes. Heave ho. And it's off the mark.
All right, at the end of the third quarter, Lady Dragons holding on to a 9-point advantage, 30-21. And we're going to take a break and be back here in just a moment. CNS Outdoor Power Equipment owners Richie and Amy Miller, located on North Michigan Street in Argus, 574-892-5790. Hours of operation Tuesday through Saturday, 8:30 through 5. They have Toro, Kohler, steel, mowers, trimmers, chainsaws, snowblowers, and much more. Chainsaw sharpening service, lawnmower repair, on-site service calls are available. Pickup and delivery also available. Right across the parking lot from CNS Outdoor Power Equipment is CNS Automotive, also owned by Richie and Amy Miller. Phone number for CNS Automotive is 574-892-9100. Full service auto repair. They do oil changes, AC service, tune-ups, diagnostic services, tire repair, tire sales, and much, much more. 8 minutes left to go here, Andy. Nine-point lead for the Lady Dragons, but the Nolans are warming up. Sophia had a big quarter right there. She's got 4, 7, 8, 9, 10 on the game now for the Lady Blazers.
So. Well, the Dragons have done very well holding the girls down. But it's a tough, tough team, and let's see what happens now.
9 points is not a big lead, probably for a team like Marquette, so we got to keep your foot down on them and playing some tough defense. Three over here on the wing for Stricker to guard.
Crook tries it and gets it to roll. I don't know how, but it went in, and that's all that matters.
Fifth point of the game for Morgan Crook. She's got a three and then that drive right there, so she's starting to warm up as well. Need to take it to them. They've got foul trouble galore. Do the Lady Blazers.
Barlow gets it. Dunlap tells them to clear out. Stricker wide open, puts it in for two. What vision out of Dunlap. Great bucket by Stricker, sneaking in. And there's a kick by Binkley again. It's her fourth of the night. She's trying to score a goal. I swear she's doing that.
She's already committed. She doesn't need to impress any soccer coaches here tonight.
That's what you like, fast, quick feet, tense defense. Dragon stepping out, 2-3 zone. Crook tries to get it, kicks all the way. Kind of a wild pass. Back over to Crook. Dunlap's on her. Crook can't go anywhere. It's loose. And it's thrown. It's stolen by Dunlap. Dunlap takes it down. Loses it. Picked up by Morgan Dunlap. Back over to Binkley.
Coach Teal's telling him to slow it down. Take your time. We've got a 32-23 lead. 6.5 minutes left.
Barlow gets it out. Binkley. Stricker wide open for three. Oh, it's in and out. It's a good quality shot. Stricker stands her ground. No one misses. Comes off out of bounds and catches the ball. Takes it up. Misses. Barlow with the foul.
Well, if you reestablish your position with both feet in bounds before you touch the ball, that's okay. And I guess that's what they're saying was what happened there for Nolan.
And still, she got three chances. Shots out of that team, and I cannot believe. And it's just got to be because of the intensity of the Lady Dragons.
All right, Emma Nolan at the line. Sophia Nolan at the line, shooting
that's
two.
That's four for Barlow. Already four? That's only her third, isn't it?
I've only got her for three.
Yeah.
Nolan puts in the free throw.
And now comes Barlow and goes Koontz. That's her fourth?
I got three. I don't know where they're getting four from. I mean, they're the official scorers, but I sure don't have four for Anna.
Well, it's going to have to be a long-fought game. Koontz is going to have to step it up.
6 minutes to go here. Second free throw for Nolan is good.
Hands on her.
A little full-court pressure here by the Lady Blazers. Knocked out of bounds. It's going to stay Lady Dragons ball, but everybody kind of left Courtney, and they had three Lady Blazers guarding her.
Well, I didn't realize that Barlow had four. So
me neither. I didn't have her down for four. Does Doug have her down for four?
I don't know. Dunlap pulls back. Looks. Binkley. Foul.
It's going to be on Joseph. That's her third. And team's fourth. 7-point Lady Dragon
lead. Well, the
lead.
Dragons need to penetrate, get some chances for some rebounds, because now they got Emma Nolan back in, and she needs to get her fifth. Tapped. Dunlap has it. Stricker with the back door. Oh, and she saw it and was a little late. And that would have been a great opportunity for a help side foul from one of the Nolans. Tipped out, and it's going to be Dragons ball.
Tried to wrap it around number 12, Dia Rawlings, and she got her hand in there and knocks it out.
Koontz gets the ball in, kicks it over to Dunlap.
A lot of hands there by Sophia. Dunlap's got to take it to Crook. She's got four fouls. Three fouls.
Three. Stricker. Binkley in the corner. Down to Koontz. Koontz back over to Dunlap. Reach in, not called. Now it's a breakaway. Misses. Rebound Koontz. And there's going to be a jump ball.
It's going to go Argus on the jump ball call.
War of attrition. And right now the clock is working its way down slowly.
Need to send a text down there to Brandon. And
yeah. They don't look at that during the game. Hands all over. I can't believe they could just hold them from, let them from going. Foul. Cook. Well, we got a fan who's a little bit red-faced and angry on Crook.
Fourth team foul, or fourth personal foul on Morgan Crook. Fifth team foul on the Lady Blazers. Good strong ball handling that time by Stricker. Able to get the call finally.
Well, I can't believe how much they're holding Dunlap when she's making a break for the ball. Now Dunlap needs to take it at Crook. Shot. Off the mark. Rebound Nolan and hits an on throw with the Nolan. Puts it in for two. Dragons need to relax.
Coach Teal's going to get a timeout with 4:21 left to go. The Lady Blazers have closed the lead to 5, 32-27. And the Lady Dragons are trying to hold on and see if they can knock off number one here. We got 4.5 minutes left to go. Argus Do It Best, located at 200 West Walnut Street in Argus, Indiana. Give them a call at 574-892-6700. A full-service hardware store. They've got hardware, paint mixing, automotive, lawn and garden, which you don't need much of right now. They've got all kinds of salt and ice melt and snow shovels and all the good stuff that you need when it's 65 below zero like it was yesterday morning.
When it's 6,000 degrees below. A lot of time left in the game. I tell you, it's just one of those nerve-wracking situations. Dragons need to come out, keep playing very tough defense.
Well, there's two Marquette players in foul trouble big time. Emma Nolan has four, and Morgan Crook has four. Sophia Nolan only has two. Emery Joseph is in three fouls. So Joseph is in, both Nolans are in, and Crook is in. So Lady Dragons need to
drive to the bucket. We got two players with four fouls, one player with three. They need to create something. Kuntz gets it. Back over to Stricker. Binkley. Look at the hands all over. I cannot believe that that's not a foul.
We're going to say it went off of a Marquette player out of bounds. It's going to be Lady Dragons' ball.
Should have been a foul anyways. Aye. But here we go. Stricker. Good work out of Stricker. Dribble out of problems. Back door to Dunlap. Dunlap looks and relaxes. She's in the corner and loses it. All the way in the corner. Crook to Nolan. Puts it up and it's in. Binkley gets it and it's thrown away. And it's saved. Binkley, ball's loose. Dunlap gets it. Get the foul. There it is. And that's the fourth or fifth foul. Emma Nolan.
That's going to be Emma's fifth foul. She's going to have to check out. 3:17 to go. Three-point game here. 32-29. Lady Dragons holding on. But big-time play right there. And Nolan's going to go out. That's the 16th foul on the Lady Blazers. So it's going to come down to some free throws here before this one's over.
And
here
comes Barlow again. Kuntz is out. Well,
Binkley, Stricker,
Dunlap,
and Barlow for the Lady Dragons.
Oh, Dunlap turns it over. Rebound, Dunlap. Foul.
That's going to be on number 21, Joseph, and that's going to be her fourth foul, and that's going to put the Lady Dragons at the line. Courtney Dunlap's going to shoot 1-1 here with 3:05 left to go. Got to hit both of these.
Big free throws. I don't know. We've talked about it before, the inconsistency of the officiating staffs at times. It has been an all-out brawl, nothing's called, and then touch fouls. I don't understand it. Dunlap makes the first one.
Her eighth of the game. Gives them a four-point lead, 33-29, 3:05 left to go. Dunlap has one more here. And second one is good as well.
Kicks it up. Travels.
Loses it out of bounds. Crook falls down and creates a third turnover of the quarter here for Marquette.
Well, once in a while you need a bit of luck, and that will do it. And that will rattle Crook. She is absolutely rattled.
Did Boyd have his foot out up there?
Kennedy Binkley gets the ball. Gives it back to Stricker. Stricker fakes, sets it up. They need to go at Crook. Oh, picks her pocket. Crook with a great little play. And Morgan Dunlap's creating a little bit of a slowdown. And there's nothing wrong with that. Crook with the ball into Nolan. Nolan throws it in. No, rebound. And there's a foul, and Dunlap's going back to the line.
Silly foul that time by Dia Rawlings, 99 feet away from the basket. And she's going to put Courtney Dunlap at the line shooting 1-1. Oh, I'm losing my voice here, Andy.
Well, I kind of been just letting the flow go because you can't keep up when they are dead sprint. And it's better just to let the people watch them go bananas than try to call it.
All right, first free throw here for Dunlap is good. I got to start a new column here. She's had 10 free throws made.
10 free throws made for Dunlap already. Wow. Here we go. She's going to put in the 11th and get the Dragons back up to 7. Let's see. And it's in.
That's what my Culver math says. 7
here we
points.
Go. Let's go. Dragons going to D it up.
No threes Brooke. Here, girls.
No one. Dunlap's on no one.
Make them run some clock right here.
No one kicks it out. It's just tipped by Binkley. Sophomore's got Binkley on her. And it's stolen by Morgan Dunlap, the freshman. She's going coast to coast. Puts it up. And it's in. And there's a timeout by Michigan City Blazers.
2:11 left to go here in the game. We got a 38-29 Argus lead. And Lady Blazers coach Katie Culligan calls a timeout. I'm sure it's not Culligan. Culligan, I don't know. But, Mr. Trophy run by the very lovely Amy Stone, located at 200 West Walnut in Argus. Give her a call, 574-892-5005. They got plaques, trophies, engravings. They are your award source in Argus, Indiana since 1975.
Channel 22 tweets out. If Indiana doesn't consider Courtney Dunlap an all-state type of player, then you might as well say that they don't consider small schools. Oh my, what a shout out. Now listen to the crowd. It's a pandemonium here.
23 points on the game for Courtney.
Oh my. Dragons kick it back to Nolan. Nolan for a quick three. She doesn't set up and she misses. Rebound, Barlow kicks it over to Dunlap. Over to Stricker. And here comes the Lady Dragons. 2 minutes left. And there's a foul in the back. And now Stricker's shooting 1-1 from the line.
All right, let's see if Macy can put in a free throw here for the Lady Dragons. Minute 59 left to go. 38-29 is your score. Use your legs, Macy. Come on, baby.
Yes. Gets the first one in.
Makes it a 10-point lead. Second one is good. No. Off the mark. Minute 57, 10-point lead for the Lady Dragons.
Down. No one puts it up, and it's a good bucket. Barlow smart without getting the foul. Here comes Dunlap. She breaks him. Gets the ball over to Stricker, and they relax. Binkley. Courtney Dunlap gets the ball way out top. Crook tries to get it. Stricker has it.
Well, she's not going to foul her. You know Crook's got four. So
yep. Binkley goes. Reached in. Gives it back over. She already got rid of the ball, and they call a travel.
Oh, boy.
Minute 25 left.
Fifth turnover of the quarter for the Lady Dragons. An 8-point lead. Minute 25 left to go. And they got to get up there. Okay, they can't let them roll the ball and not get the clock started.
Ooh, a straight hand. There's the ball loose. The ball's loose.
Binkley, hold on to it, Morgan.
Travels.
Huge hustle play that time by Binkley, and good effort there by Morgan Dunlap, the freshman.
I cannot believe that there was a foul, but it was ball loose. Everybody's scattering, bodies flying. Somebody's got to go up
get,
there.
They're letting time run off the clock. We're not run off the clock.
Crook tries to get it down, forcing it to no one. It's not going to get there. Binkley. They're trying to get it over to no one. Tong three, and it's in and out. Barlow with the huge rebound, and there's a fifth foul on Crook. And Barlow's going to the line. Shooting two.
Double bonus time for the Lady Dragons, and Morgan Crook has just fouled out of the game for the Lady Blazers. Number 10, Mackenzie Maravich, is going to check back in. And Anna Barlow is going to the line shooting two with 58.6 seconds left to go here. We are less than a minute away from a huge upset here at Phil Waitbright Gymnasium.
We're playing outstanding, but this may be a bad thing. Yes, Barlow makes it. Bad for maybe a possible rematch in sectional-type games.
No, it's not.
All right.
No, it's not.
It's well worth it. Barlow puts
it. Two for two. Anna Barlow, good job. 41-31, under a minute to go.
And oh my word, Dragons come out and play the game of their season, and they are doing outstanding. A quick three. She's not even checking up to square up. And three bound for Stricker. Kicks it over. Dunlap. Binkley wide open.
Hold
Binkley
it up. Hold it up,
down,
Kenny.
And gives it to Morgan Dunlap. Puts it in. Okay. And it's a great bucket okay. out of the Dragons.
Okay, don't hold it up if you got that shot opportunity. Good job, Binkley.
Long three. It's a rush shot. It's in and out. Barlow with another rebound. Stricker gets the ball. And it's going to be a jump ball.
Timeout. Coach Teal.
And Coach Teal calls
Coach
a timeout.
Coach Teal, timeout. 24.9. Good call by Coach Teal. 43-31 is the score. And good hustle effort that time by Macy Stricker. And the Lady Dragons are on their way. They've got a 12-point lead. Hey, looky there. There's your
yep.
bald buddy,
there
Mr.
There goes
Minix
and the gang flipping out. They were here watching. We've got players and scouts from all over the place, and they are going to be nervous. Oregon Davis will be nervous to play the Lady Dragons after this performance. And there you see Bailey Nifong waving to Minix as he went out the door. Yeah. Oh, boy.
All right. Well, nice. You've talked in previous times about how impressed you are with the shine that he keeps. You know,
he does.
You both
He's
being
got it
of
going
the
on.
You know,
nature.
Hairless head nature. And
I got to figure it out. Yeah. He's buffing it.
You're just going to have to go up there to him and say, Terry, give me your tips.
Terry, tell you me know, what you think.
Is it a 4.5-inch angle grinder with a buffer head, or what do you got going on there? So, oh, boy, if we're getting a little giddy, it's acceptable today. 24.9 left to go. 12-point Dragon advantage is the biggest lead of the game for the
biggest
Lady Dragons.
Biggest lead of the game. And listen to the crowd.
You got to, I told them they had to keep them close to their average on defense, and they're doing it. 25 points. They're just 31 points for Michigan City.
Morgan Dunlap comes across the line, gives it over to Courtney, and she's fouled immediately. Shooting
Maravich,
two.
That's her first foul of the game, but at this point it's a little moot right now.
I don't know.
Let's keep sending Courtney to the line. She's only made 11 free throws
I
in the game.
I would hate for us to keep running the score up by free throws.
Well, if they're fouling us, we got to keep making them.
Well, here we go. Shooting two. Dunlap going to add to her tally. And she does.
12th free throw made of the night for Courtney.
I think we'll have to have a little interview tonight. What do you think? I want to talk to Coach Teal after this one. Dunlap getting ready to shoot another. And it's good.
13 free throws in the night for Dunlap. And 12.
Hands up.
25 for Dunlap.
NBA three, and it's short.
Rebound.
Morgan Dunlap over to Courtney. And the Dragons are going to go. And listen to the crowd come to their feet.
3-2-1, and that's going to do it. Lady
what
Dragons pull
Lady
off
Dragons.
The victory. 45-31 over the number one team in Class A. Michigan City Marquette, what a job by the Lady Dragons, holding Marquette almost half of their normal output. They're scoring 62. They're right at half of their normal offensive output.
Yep. Oh, my. What a game out of the Lady Dragons.
Well,
holy
we talked
cow.
About we talked about it in the pregame. The keys to the game for Argus would be tough defense. Anna, Macy, Kennedy, Emily, Morgan would have to step up big time. Well, Courtney stepped up huge, and you had great games from Macy Stricker, Anna Barlow, Kennedy Binkley, Woo. Morgan Dunlap with a tremendous game. And, wow, I just I can't believe it. I'm going to total up some stats for
All right,
us here.
I'm going to go see if I can locate. I want to get Dunlap, and, well, let's get a few people up here.
Get
we
whoever
talk
you
to
can get. Coach Teal, definitely.
Oh,
we need to get him on board. And so we're going to take a break. We'll just put it on the slideshow here for a little bit. We'll get some totals here and then get back to do some interviews.
We'll be using this.
No, because that kills our sound. So you gotta use that.
Oh, muggle. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 25.
That was a great game.
2, 2, 4, 5, 3, 6.
Yeah. Oh, my word. Oh, I got Stevie's headset.
Okay, well, we talked about it before the game that the Dragons are going to have to come out with defense. And when they hold number one in the state, ah, you're killing me.
Come on here. Are you ready?
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. I already told them and they're letting us know.
Give it.
Okay. All right, this is your average point.
We're on TV. Yeah.
We have to. 31.
Yeah.
I told him to get out too.
I got lead too.
Okay. Is that us?
Oh, my.
All right, we're going to switch it.
All right, welcome back here. Phil Haybright Gymnasium, the Argus Lady Dragons have pulled off the tremendous upset of the Class A number one Michigan City Lady Blazers, 45-31, and they scored 31 points. Their average on the season, the Lady Blazers, is 62.3.
62, we held them to half. What was the shooting percentage at the end of the game? But I know at halftime they were down, and we were just defensively shutting them down. What did we hold them to first half? What was it? 10 points, I think?
Doug's got 10 points. Points at the half, yes. 21-10 at the half.
That is just tremendous.
21 points for the second half. That's still tremendous. So
yeah.
With the scoring totals here for the Lady Blazers, Sophia Nolan leads their team with 12. Morgan Crook has 5. Listen to this. Sophia Nolan with 12. She averages 18.
Yep.
Okay. Emma Nolan has 9. She averages 16.
Wow.
Morgan Crook averages 10. She gets 5.
5.
Hannah Nolan comes in and has 5 points for the Lady Blazers. They have 4 turnovers. Let's see, 4. They had 6 in the first half, and they had 5. Only 11 turnovers for the game for the Lady Blazers, which is pretty clean. For your Lady Dragons, of course, Courtney Dunlap with 25 points. She made 13 free throws. Over half of her
13
points.
13 free throws? Wow.
Morgan Dunlap scores 6. Macy Stricker with 5. Anna Barlow with 4. Emily Calhoun with a huge 3 there to start the half.
Second half. Oh, my.
And Kennedy Binkley with a bucket. And Lady Dragons with 5. I only got them basically with 10 turnovers in the game. So pretty clean game. But the defensive effort of the Argus Lady Dragons is what won the night for them.
It was the defense and then just smart high percentage shots. That was what I was very impressed. We had a lot of bunnies or layups type plays due to the fact that they'd collapse on Dunlap and we'd whip it in, or just we would constantly rotate the ball and get a good shot, a high percentage shot. And then when we did take a chance with the 3, we didn't do a lot of them tonight, but Calhoun's was huge. And then the steal for Dunlap to get that lay-in really started sparking the offensive attack.
Here, I'm going to let you.
And here we go. What a pass. We were trying to get a player, but the little camera shy. That's just how it goes. So tremendous work. So I'm going to get Macy Stricker in.
Let Andy do it.
Arrgh. All right. Macy's ultra excited. Don't look at the camera or nothing. So how big a victory is that for you guys?
Oh, it's huge. We just got knocked down to number 3, but I think they made a huge mistake.
Well, I couldn't have said it better myself. I tell you what, we knew it was a big game. You have our lovely presence here tonight, but then you have Doug Griffiths in from the pilot. You have Channel 22. You got Channel 16 on the tip-off before the game even started out on the court. It was a huge, huge game. And, boy, did you guys not disappoint.
No, we had too many fans here to disappoint for tonight.
Oh, I tell you, the teamwork was outstanding. Everybody came to it. I talked to you a little bit before the game saying, hey, we need 16 out of you to really give us that fighting edge to go after it. But you know what? When it come down to it, we didn't need all the points. We just needed that tough defense you guys had.
Yeah, that was the key. We needed to stop the Nolan girls, and we did. And also Crook, she's been shooting threes this year, and she airballed that first one, and she was done.
Yeah, there was a lot of frustration out of the players, and that's just because of the tenacity as you girls showed as a team all over them. I don't know if you realize that they averaged 62 points. You guys held them to 31. 10 points first half only for them. They were 2 of 17 from the field. That's pretty impressive.
So, you know, you had a couple of good opportunities. We liked the high-quality shots that the Dragons were shooting tonight. And that's, you know, when everybody came in, they did what they had to do. Barlow got in a little bit of foul trouble, but you guys managed to work through that. So, but I want to tell you congratulations. There was a lot of people counting the different score. Obviously, you know, John Harrell did not predict this win. A lot of people said we were going to lose by 12, but, in fact, we won by a fair amount tonight, huh?
Yeah.
She's not much for interviews, as you can tell. She's a little nervous, but, hey, I want to tell you congratulations and very good game, outstanding work. Even if you don't score 100 points, holding them down and beating them with just a pure frustration, and it works. Defense wins championships.
That's for sure.
All righty. Well, we're going to get the next person up here. We're trying to get Dunlap and or a couple other players, but so far they haven't made it up here. And I'm going to see what we can do. See them right down there talking. Go down there and yell at them and see what we can do to get Dunlap up here. So I tell you what, a couple of stats here. While we're waiting, I'm going to bring in Doug Griffiths over here. Oh, wait, he's going to talk to Coach Teal. Well, we're trying to get Teal up here first. See what we can do. Here he comes. He's the man. You know, I talked to Coach Kelsey and then before the game and said that we're going to do what we always do, but we're going to step it up intensity-wise, and, boy, did it pay off. First half, holding them to 10 points, that's just tremendous. All right, so I got Anna Barlow coming over, and we're going to have Anna Barlow come in here. She's in the hot seat today. All right, go ahead and get your headphones on. All right, Anna, well, how you feeling?
Well, after that win, I feel pretty good.
I tell you what, a lot of people had us down for the count, and you guys played your best team performance.
Yeah, I agree.
So we talked about keys of winning the game and being tough on the boards, and I'm not sure on the stats. I haven't got them down there as far as rebounds, but the crucial rebounds you had is the ones where you drew the over-the-back fouls.
Yeah.
So what was your thoughts on the performance tonight?
I thought everyone did extraordinary. Everyone knew, like, everybody knew their role, and we all executed, so that's how we won.
It was. It was a total team performance. I don't know. You guys, they averaged 62 points a game. You held them to half of that for a total game. First half, you held them to 10 points, 2 of 17 from the field. That is such a major, major accomplishment defensively. I tell you, I can't tell you how proud we all are. Everybody was beyond excited. The crowd was into it. And, you know, I think that they're going to give us newfound respect here. What
yeah,
do you think?
I agree. Maybe they won't put us in third anymore.
Macy said the same thing, and I know you girls take that to heart, but that's just a number. But I tell you what, Macy said it best. They moved us to number 3, and I think they made a mistake.
Yep, I agree.
So, well, I tell you what a way to come out. You guys have just passed your best all-time start for a regular season. Now you're 11-0, taking out number 1. Both teams undefeated, one left with a defeat, and it's not the Lady Dragons. Well, congratulations, and what a great game.
Thank you.
All righty. So we got Binkley over here. She looks nervous and excited all at once. So, Kennedy Binkley.
Thank you. Ginsburg, Anna.
Let me just get this stat sheet. I can't even count the massive amount of points she had tonight. Binkley with, let me see, 2. But you know what?
Hey, that's a record.
But that was a great 2 points. It was when we needed it, and it was what we were doing by all-out hustle and good vision from the team.
Yeah.
So, you know, we talked about defense being the key, and you're one of the main defenders. You know, lots of tips, loose balls, and action on the ground. You know, what do you think was the biggest turning point for the game?
Well, honestly, I think it was at halftime when we held them to 10 points. I mean, that's a huge defensive win for us right there.
Well, I tell you what, I can't agree more. When you guys can hold a team like this, there's not a single player that got near their average. Almost every player on their team was half of what they average per game. And then you held the entire team to half of what they get. You know, we've talked about it in multiple sports. We've always talked about offense will win a game, but defense wins championships. And, you know, it was a big part of the team last year.
Yeah, I really agree with that. I think that everyone knows on the team that defense is what wins games, and everyone knows, like, their role in defense and on the team, and I think that's what really wins us the game because we play as a team.
You got that right. Everybody was working hard. You know, we were kind of nervous, not sure what was going to happen, if they were going to come out, you know, firing on all pistons with a massive halftime speech from their coach. And then, you know, a little quiet Emily Calhoun comes out and sinks a big three right at the beginning. And it kind of sparked us. And then we got in a little bit of a lull. But then the defense took over, took a couple of balls away. We got a few points, a few free throws. And then the steal from Dunlap to get the lay-in kind of really energized the entire team. And you could hear the crowd, and instantly they're calling timeout. And it makes all the difference. So I want to congratulate you on a huge, huge victory as a great team win. And as a senior, I mean, it doesn't get any better than knocking off number one.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Well, we've talked about it. Many people have. We're a small school. We're public school. We just play with what we have. And I tell you what, when you guys work hard, this was by far your best performance, the toughest competition, and you guys handled it with aces. I love it.
We do, too.
All right. Well, I want to appreciate thank you for coming in. We're going to try to get Courtney up here and then Coach Teal as soon as he gets done. And, well, it looks like he's almost free. So great game out of Binkley. Another quality performance defensively. And, you know, it's all part of being a team, and it shows.
Thank you.
All right, congratulations.
Thank you.
So here we are. We got Coach Teal. He looks like he's coming over here now. He's got his little book, and we're going to put him on the spot for a second. All right. So Coach Teal's coming in. And Mr. Look at him, relaxed, calm, cool. Wow, this is nothing. This wasn't much.
Had about 27 million more gray hairs.
Well, you know, they say you earn every gray hair. I think you got a few extras tonight.
Yes. just, you know, so proud of the kids. You know, we came up with a game plan, what we felt we needed to do to be successful tonight, and they followed that game plan, and I'm just so proud of them. I mean, they deserve the credit. They're the ones who were out there fighting, following the game plan, what we wanted, and did the things correctly. They fought hard. They never gave up. We knew that Marquette was going to make a run on us. I hope they didn't, but, you know, you knew that was coming sometime.
Yep.
And they started double-teaming Courtney and got a few wide-open breaks on the lay-in, and we got that stopped. And what was big is we got, you know, the steal from Morgan Dunlap and a score. That was big to get it, push that lead back to, I think, after getting down to three, that pushed it back to eight or seven or eight.
Seven or eight. Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was up to seven, and then it kind of re-energized the whole team.
Yes.
It was just, well, one, and then the crowd went, and then they just fed off the energy of the crowd.
Right. The crowd was great. The fan base, the student body, you know, they were cheering, and that just meant so much for our fans and our student body to be here cheering us on in this big victory, and we give them a lot of credit as a six-man award tonight.
Oh, yeah. It was. I tell you what, we talked about it. We talked about, some of the numbers, and you probably know a little bit, but you know you were so focused on the game, you're not focused on that. But they averaged 62. You held them to 31.
Right.
10 first half points, 2 of 17 from the field. That is a tremendous, tremendous defensive effort.
Well, you know, and just, you know, the kids take so much pride in their defense and being ranked, you know, number one right now on defense in the state. I mean, the kids take pride in that. And we've always talked about on a night that you don't shoot the ball well, you have to play great defense. You know, case in point, against CGA, we shot 27%, but we were still able to beat a very good basketball team that night by 6 points, and that's because of defense. And we knew, part of our game plan was we knew we had to keep the game score low. We had to control the tempo. We had to keep the game in the 30s and the 40s, and that's what the kids did. And we knew we could not get into a track meet with this team because they're just so quick, so big, so aggressive. But I thought our kids held their own. When the going got tough, they got tougher. You know, their intensity level, their energy level, the enthusiasm level was all there tonight. And, you know, especially after having 10 days off without a game, you know, having a game canceled, we missed a couple practices because of the weather. I'm just thrilled with their effort tonight. Just an outstanding effort against the number one ranked team in the state.
Well, we talked about it. We said there's a few things. We were either going to come out and be rested, or come out and be rusty.
Right.
And luckily it was the rested part. And, you know, I talked to some of the keys of the game for winning this would be battling on the boards sometimes. And I told Anna, I said, there was three biggest rebounds that you had tonight was the ones that you drew over the backs on everyone.
Every time.
And that really hurt. And when, you know, the Nolan girls are very tough, the twins are just amazing young players, and they've got a bright future. But when you bring them off with four fouls and to come off the court crying, you know that you have done your job. And you don't want to see that out of a player, but that's how frustrated and how hard they were trying to do something, and we were able to break them down.
Right.
And that's just amazing.
You know, and it takes great communication on your defense. And our kids had great communication tonight on our defensive effort. And, you know, with Rachel coming in, Koontz, she gave us a good spell in there tonight with when Anna was in foul trouble and the kids helped her know where she needed to be. And I thought Morgan Dunlap also came off the bench and did a great job for us as well. So the team communication and the kids have bought into that and they do a great job helping each other. We've really been working hard on blocking out because we knew that we could not give them putbacks. And I thought the kids did a great job controlling the defensive boards tonight and not giving them a lot of second chance opportunities. And that was big as well as the defense. And then, you know, the free throws down the stretch.
Yeah, that was impressive.
Last quarter, you know, Courtney goes six for six. Anna goes 2 for 2. And Macy goes 1 for 2, so we're 9 for 10 in that last quarter,
and that's big to seal a game.
I'll
take that, especially when they're tired. They've been working hard the entire game, you know. And to be honest, Stricker's had a little bit of problems going the full length, back to forth, and tonight she handled it with aces. She was tremendous.
She handled it well, you know. Stayed out of foul trouble, did her job. You know, got a lot of big key rebounds in that first half. You know, off the backside,
backside rebounds.
So just, you know, great effort out of each one of the kids. You know, we couldn't have done it without all seven kids that participated, as well as the five kids on the bench who were cheering their teammates on, as well as the student body and our fan base who supported the Lady Dragons tonight in this big game. We couldn't have done it without any of those people.
Well, I got to tell you what, you officially passed the best start record. You are now...
What a way to pass it.
Beat out number one. And I think Macy said it best. I got to quote her. They moved us to number three, and I think they made a mistake. So you got to love it. A little bit of arrogance, but a whole lot of pride. And how could you be wrong with a team that's so prideful of a great accomplishment such as this game?
Right, exactly. I'm just, you know, ecstatic right now. I'm so proud of them, and like you, it brings tears to my eyes.
Yeah,
you know,
just a little bit. I love it.
It's a great thing.
It is
a great thing. You know, just an outstanding effort at home, protecting the den, and so proud of them.
Well, I tell you, it's a tough place to come to play when we are, you know, a full force in the fan base. And it's this gym has got a ton of history. And every season with these girls, you just keep adding more and more. And I want to appreciate and tell you thank you for that.
Well, you're welcome. You know, I appreciate that effort. You guys do a great job as well. And I'll say too again, you know, it's, you know, we can only give those kids a game plan and work with them in practice, and they're the ones that have to put it to work, and they deserve the credit, you know.
Well, I tell you what, both squads doing tremendous.
Both
combined, we are undefeated, and
Kelsey's 10-0.
Yeah, it's been a long time since we've had these numbers, and we were a little bit hesitant about tonight. You know, there's a great team, a long time off, and but everybody did what they needed to do, and. And here I go. My final interview with the last player of the day, Courtney Dunlap. But Coach Teal, congratulations on
a huge
win. And I think they're going to give us a little bit more respect.
I think they will. I hope so. Congratulations to Kelsey and to JB too.
All right. There's Coach Teal. So he's going to hand over the microphone and headphones over to Courtney Dunlap. They don't do players of the game, but if they did, you know, I would say that if it was a one player, you did a tremendous job, great numbers. But I think it really comes down to the team defense.
Yeah, defense was solid. We held the number one team in the state to 10.5.
10.5, and just so you know, 2 of 17 from the field in the first half. That's a team who shoots 40% from the three-point line by themselves. And they were absolutely off. I think they only made three-pointers the entire game. Crook was only one. And, you know, every player was held for less than half of their average.
Yeah, it's amazing. It's amazing.
Tremendous. So, but you know, the game plan worked. You knew what you needed to do as a, you know, as a senior leader. You had some good vision and a ton of assists to go along with, you know, a few points. Let me see here. Oh, 25. you've once in a while in this season, you've had a little issue with some free throws here and there. But
yeah,
tonight, wow, fourth quarter free throws, tremendous.
Yeah. And maybe I need to, like, hurt my thumb every game. Cause
well, we saw it. There was a couple hard fouls. You know, you got tripped and laid out. And then you got on the baseline, you got kind of hit pretty hard. And no one really said anything. And I was like, man, she just went down hard. And, you know, we got a bucket out of it. But, you know, those are some painful fouls.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, she said. So, you know, what do you think was one of the big turning points in the first half?
I think it was just the way we came out. We came out firing, and I don't think they expected it. They were down 14-2, I think, at one point.
Yep, they were down 12. I agree 100%. They were not expecting what we just handed to them, and it caught them off guard. Second half, I'm sure you guys didn't notice. We watch everything, and Emma Nolan comes off with four fouls, and she's crying as she's coming off because they're so frustrated.
Yeah, that's what our defense is meant to do, frustrate teams.
Well, I noticed that you guys were doing a JV and varsity was doing a lot of one time down in the zone, next time you down man-to-man. Then you switch it in between the rotation, and it was really causing havoc for the offense. They couldn't get things going.
Yep, got to keep them on their toes.
Yeah, well, so with 25, let me see here, 13 free throws. Yeah, that's not bad for you, huh?
No, that's not. That's not.
Well, I got to tell you, you guys had some good plays, but I think what really sparked it to shut down the comeback as the rally they had was the steal and layup by your sister, Morgan. That really got the crowd
always,
into
she
it.
She always has those, like, those little plays that are the most important probably.
Well,
in the game.
At times, you know, but there's one word that tells you what that happens from, and that's just hustle.
Yeah.
So, you know, well, a tremendous victory, definitely what most people weren't expecting. I'm going to quote Macy Stricker. They moved us to number 3.
Exactly.
I think they made a mistake.
Don't disrespect us. That's
just, she said it. Don't make a mistake. I think they made a mistake. And, you know, it's not arrogance. I think it's just pride of a good quality team and a great team effort tonight. This is by far your guys' best game.
So. I agree.
Well, all right. Well, that's a great work out of Courtney Dunlap. There was a tweet from a little news station of 22. Did you see that?
Yeah.
If you don't consider Courtney Dunlap one of the better players in the state, then they don't consider small schools at all. And I tell you what, I can't agree more.
Yep. Hopefully we get some recognition. Not just me, but all girls at small schools who are capable of being up there with the best.
I tell you, you guys did very well. And I you know that we are a tad bit hesitant at the beginning of second half. We were wondering, all right, we're going to come out slow. Or are we going to do this? Or their team's going to fire up? And Calhoun hits a big three right at the beginning.
Yeah, that was a huge three.
It was huge three. So
we talked at halftime about how we needed to come out just like we started the game. We could not let down, and Emily hit a huge three.
Yeah, it was great work. You know, Barlow had to be tough as possible on the boards, and her biggest boards is the ones where she drew the over-the-back calls.
She did great tonight,
And it was just a great team effort out of everyone. So congratulations. You guys have officially passed the best start in school record for the girls. Something else you can rub into Coach Kelsey?
That's exactly right. I'm here to break Coach Kelsey's records.
There you go. Well, I got to tell you, we're all proud of everything you girls are doing. You know, and it means a lot to the school. It means a lot to all of us parents. And, you know, just keep up the hard work, and congratulations.
Thank you.
All righty. Well, that's going to do it for us. Courtney's out, and in comes Steve, and we are going to finish up the game here. And I tell you what. Well, Steve.
All right. You got her all wrapped up. You interviewed the whole team pretty much. Good job.
I got a few players. Emily Calhoun didn't come up. I was wanting to talk to her about her big three, but she didn't make it up here. She's pretty shy the way it is, but I want to congratulate her. That was a huge way to start the second half. Tremendous team effort. Coach Teal and I discussed it. Just all around tremendous, tremendous game. So. Well, Steve, I'm going to leave the rest to you. I can't talk anymore.
All right, we're going to wrap it up here from the Phil Waybright Gymnasium, the Dragon Den, where the Argus Lady Dragons knock off the Michigan City Marquette, number 1 in Class A. Huge, huge win here tonight for the Lady Dragons. Final score. 45-31.
I got to give you the quote of the night.
Quote of the night, okay.
Macy Stricker.
Oh, no.
Well, all they right. moved us to number three, and I think they made a mistake.
Oh, I love it.
It's
they
pure
made
pride.
A mistake.
I think
yeah.
it was pure pride. It wasn't
That wasn't
it
quite
was,
where I thought she would go with that once you said that.
It was pure pride. I love it. I think that's just tremendous and shows the heart of this team.
All right. Well, we're going to wrap it up here tonight for Andy Stone, Alex Stearns, Steve Stricker here. Thank you all for tuning in to the Argus Voice Sports on RTC4.com and Channel 4 in Rochester, and we'll see you again. Boy, I don't even know. We'll see you again on the next game. We'll tweet it out. All right. Thank you for joining us, and good night.